In this example, we're going to solve what's called an initial value problem. So an initial value problem is just a type of differential equation. But in addition to the actual differential equation itself, we're going to be given what's called an initial condition, or maybe multiple initial conditions dependent on the problem. So in this example, I'm asked to solve the initial value problem, and I'm given y prime of t equals 5 plus e to the negative 3t, and then the initial condition, y of 0 equals 7. So my goal in this problem is the same as when I'm solving other differential equations. I want to find the original equation y of t. The difference here is that instead of finding a general solution where I have some constant c, I'm going to be finding a specific or a particular solution, and I'm going to use the initial condition to do that. So let's see how this actually works out. The way I'm going to start is exactly the same. I'm going to start by finding an expression for y of t by integrating y prime of t. So I know y prime of t equals 5 plus e to the negative 3t. And I'm going to integrate both sides of this expression with respect to t. So on the left-hand side, that's just going to get me y of t equals, and if I integrate this expression, I'm going to get 5t plus negative 1/3 e to the negative 3t plus c, plus my constant of integration. Now the 1/3, you can get that by u substitution if you're not convinced of that constant out front. So this is a general solution. But like I said before, this initial condition is going to allow us to find a particular solution. So what is a general solution? Well, the general solution is a whole family of solutions that satisfies this differential equation. But what I want to find here is I want to find one particular solution. And I want to find the solution that goes through this point, y of 0 equals 7. So basically, I'm just going to use this fact, y of 0 equals 7, to solve for c. So we simply plug in. So y of 0, that means I'm plugging in 0 for t. So I plug in 0 for all my t's, and that equals 7. And then I simply solve for c. So 5 times 0 is 0, plus negative 1/3. E to the 0 is 1. So plus c equals 7. So it looks like I get c equals 7 plus 1/3, or 22/3. So then my final solution is going to be y of t equals 5t plus negative 1/3 e to the negative 3t, plus 22/3. Now, if you wanted to check your answer for an initial value problem, you would have to check two things. First of all, you'd have to check that the derivative of y of t gave you this expression up here, 5 plus e to the negative 3t, and then you'd also have to check that y of 0 equals 7. And if both of those things are true, then you know you've done the problem correctly. Let's look at another type of initial value problem that's set up as a word problem. So here's a situation. A bottle rocket is launched vertically upward from the ground with a velocity of 32 meters per second. Assume no air resistance and that the only acceleration is due to gravity and 9.8 meters per second squared. Find the position function s of t. And then at what time does a rocket reach its highest point? Okay, so our goal in this problem is to find the position and function s of t. Once we do that, we'll worry about when the rocket reaches its highest point. So how are we going to do this? Why is this an initial value problem? Well, what do we know? We know about the initial position of the rocket. which is on the ground, and about its initial velocity. And we also know what its acceleration is. So let's write down some information here. I can write this acceleration as a function, a of t. And I'm going to write a of t equals negative 9.8. So this acceleration is always negative 9.8, and that's just the acceleration due to gravity, and it's in the downward direction, and that's why it's negative. Now what I'm ultimately interested in is the position function. So let's remember the relationship between acceleration and position. Well, you may remember that the derivative of the position function is the velocity function, and then the derivative of the velocity function is the acceleration function. So really the acceleration function here, I could also call it the second derivative of the position function. So then I can now see why this is a differential equation type of problem. I'm going to start with the second derivative, s double prime of t, and then work my way up to the original function s of t. And along the way, I'm going to use this information about its initial position and its initial velocity as initial conditions to help me solve for these functions. Okay, so let's actually do the work. So, s double prime of t equals negative 9.8 is what I have so far. And I'm going to integrate both sides of that relationship with respect to t. So that's going to give me s prime of t equals negative 9.8 t plus some constant c. Now, what I'd like to do next is actually solve for this constant c. To do that, I need an initial condition. I need to know what s prime of something is, right? I need some point, the velocity at some particular point in time so that I can solve for this c. So basically, I need a condition on the velocity. Now, what we're told is that the bottle rocket is launched with a velocity of 32 meters per second. So that's what we call the initial velocity, or the velocity at time zero. So I know s prime of 0 equals 32, and I can use this to solve for my constant c. Okay, so then s prime of 0. If I plug in 0, and then set it equal to 32, I end up with c equals 32. So now I can write a more specific velocity function. S prime of t equals negative 9.8 t plus 32. Now I'm going to do the exact same thing to find the position function. So I'm going to integrate both sides of this with respect to t. So if I follow through here, I get s of t equals, so let's see, this is negative 9.8 over 2t squared plus 32t plus some constant of integration c. Now once again, I'd like to solve for that constant of integration, so I need some sort of condition. I need s of something equals something, so that I have something to plug in to solve for c. So are we given an initial condition or some other point on the position curve? Well, we're told the bottle rocket is launched from the ground. And that actually tells us its initial position. So I can say the position at time 0 is 0. It's on the ground, so it's 0 meters high. So if I plug in 0 for t here, I get this is negative 4.9 times 0 plus 32 times 0 plus c equals 0. So that tells me that c equals 0. So then my position function is negative 4.9 t squared plus 32 t. So So we've answered the first part of the problem. We found our position function. Now the second part of the problem asks, at what time does a rocket reach its highest point? So to help us think about how to answer this question, let's very briefly just look at a graph of this position function. So here it is. Down here is my t-axis, and then this is s of t, the position function. So you'll notice I'm starting here on the ground. So at time 0, I am at a position of 0. So all this part should just be ignored here, because we don't really want to think about times less than 0, because that doesn't make sense. So my rocket starts here. It goes upward. And as it goes up, this is the position function. So this is showing the position, but you can imagine that the velocity of the rocket is getting slower and slower, right, as gravity is causing this deceleration. So then at some point, the rocket's going to reach its highest point, and then it's going to start falling downward again. Okay. So then what we're interested in is the time when the rocket reaches its highest point. So somewhere approximately where I drew the star. So really what we're doing is we're looking for the maximum value of the position function s of t. Right here. So you might remember how to find maximum values. It's going to involve the derivative of the position function. So actually what's going to happen here is this is going to happen when the velocity equals 0. Or I can say the derivative of the position function equals 0. Now we already found the velocity function, so we don't need to redo that. We found that s prime of t equals negative 9.8 t plus 32. So I just need to solve for the time when this equals 0. So I'm simply solving this expression here. So 9.8 t equals 32, and I get t equals 32 divided by 9.8. Which you work that out, it is approximately 3.3 seconds. Which if we look back at our graph, looks about reasonable. Okay, so the rocket reaches its highest point at about 3.3 seconds. So the time the rocket reaches its highest point wasn't really the new part here. The new part was finding this position function. So just a quick review, we knew the second derivative based on the acceleration. And so we solved this differential equation to get to the original function s of t, and along the way we had to use some initial conditions about some information about the velocity at a point in time and about the position at a point in time. And that allowed us to get a particular solution here, this position function.